everyone. In the last class we have already started the linear algebra, some basic topics. So in the basic topics we have already discussed about the some different kinds of the matrices, column matrix, square matrix, diagonal matrix, identity matrix, singular matrix, and how to take the addition of the matrices and subtraction of the matrices, scalar multiplication of matrices, and also some products of the matrices. In the product of the matrices we have already discussed also the some properties of the matrix multiplications. Now I'm taking the topic that is in the basic, some more basic topics will be needed for further simplifications, so that why I'm taking a some more basic topics here before going to start the syllabus. So those are orthogonal matrix. So what is the orthogonal matrix? So orthogonal matrix is a square matrix, is said to be orthogonal. A square matrix is said to be orthogonal. A square matrix is said to be orthogonal if A into transpose of A should be equal to I, or transpose of A into A should be equal to I. Then we say that a square matrix is a orthogonal. And also singular matrix and non-singular matrix. Singular matrix and non-singular matrix. Singular matrix means, suppose A is a square matrix, if the determinant of A is equal to 0, then it is a singular. If the determinant of A is not equal to 0, then it is non-singular. If the determinant of A is 0, then it is a singular matrix. If the determinant of A is not equal to 0, then it is a non-singular matrix. And you already know the inverse of a square matrix. Inverse of a square matrix. If A and B are the two square matrices, then if AB equal to BA equal to I, then B is called the inverse of A. Then B is called the inverse of A, and that is denoted by inverse of A. Now, this inverse of A can also be found only if the determinant of A is not equal to 0. Means inverse of A is exist only for the non-singular matrices. Only for the non-singular matrices. And some important note of these will be, the inverse of a square matrix is, the inverse of the matrix is unique. It will not be changed by any methods. Inverse of A is unique. And second one, inverse of AB equal to inverse of B into inverse of A. So next I am taking adjoint of a matrix. How to find the adjoint? Finding the adjoint of a matrix. All these topics you have already read in your previous years. So adjoint of A is equals to, suppose A equal to A11, A12, A13, A21, A22, A23, A31, A32, A33. So this is already have noted that adjoint of a matrix A is equals to, adjoint of the matrix A is equals to A11, A12, A13, A21, A22, A23, A31, A32, A33. Those are called these A11, A12, A21, capital. That in generally I take it as Aij is a cofactor of respected Aij. a11 is the capital a11 is the cofactor of a11, a12 is the cofactor of a12, a13 is the cofactor of a13. Those are called the cofactors. So that is adjoint of a matrix. And this adjoint of matrix is taken like this, adjoint of